Faced with the threat of persistent hurricanes and destructive storm surges, North Carolina homeowners are fortifying their shorelines with human-made seawalls and bulkheads. But should they? We asked Carter Smith at UNC Chapel Hill's Institute of Marine Sciences.
A natural shoreline or a living shoreline is some kind of shoreline that incorporates natural habitat elements. So for instance, it could range from just a normal natural salt marsh or restored salt marsh or oyster reef all the way up to an offshore breakwater or something that helps to protect those natural elements. And then ranging on the more highly engineered side, we have things that are called hardened shorelines. And hardened shorelines could be a seawall that you see along a beach or an estuarine shoreline, or a bulkhead, which are sort of scaled down smaller versions of seawalls. So we were really interested in understanding the decisions that homeowners in North Carolina make when they're deciding how to protect their shorelines from hurricanes. We interviewed about 800 homeowners in North Carolina, and when we asked homeowners to rate different types of structures based on their effectiveness, their cost, and their durability, they assumed that bulkheads were their best stabilization option. And so then when we went out into the field and we looked at how bulkheads actually performed during hurricanes, we found that about 95% of the visual damage that we saw from the storm could be attributed to bulkhead shorelines. Typically, the way that these shoreline structures are built is that they're meant to withstand wave force coming from the side of the water. If that water overtops the structure and gets behind it, it pushes back on the structure and it pushes that structure towards the water. And that can ultimately lead to them collapsing or breaching or lead to landward erosion right behind the structures. Before and after Hurricane Matthew, we had a study in North Carolina that actually went out to sites all across the coast. And we found actually that living shorelines did just as well at maintaining elevation from before to after the storm as bulkheads. But the cool thing about living shorelines was that they required absolutely no repair after the storm, whereas 3 out of the 4 bulkheads that we surveyed in our study required some kind of repair. So natural shorelines can be very resistant to hurricanes for a couple of different reasons. So when you think about a salt marsh, you have an area that's filled with hundreds of thousands of little stems, and each of those stems are actually offering resistance to the water and the waves when they're coming in. And that would be similar for an offshore oyster reef, in that it makes the waves shoal a little bit earlier and it slows some of that wave velocity when it's coming in. We know from going out and surveying after Hurricane Florence that there's been a ton of shoreline damage, at least in this area of North Carolina, and a lot of it again can be attributed to hardened shorelines. And so this suggests that bulkheads are being damaged quite a lot, so they're not very durable. They're requiring a lot of maintenance. They might not be as effective as homeowners think that they are. And if you have to go back and rebuild your bulkhead after every single storm, that's going to be really expensive in the long term.